Union leaders were back at it today, spending hours at the negotiating table. RWJ University Hospital and the union representing 1,700 nurses are still locked in a bitter debate over contracts, nearly 3 months after the nurses went on strike. A senior correspondent, Joanna Gagas, reports both sides are locked in but eager to cut a deal.
It's time to end it and go back to work. I think we're on day 77.
Day 77 of a nursing strike that's left both sides frustrated and left nearly 1,700 nurses without work, pay, or benefits for more than 2 months now.
It has gone on way too long. It's time to resolve this and go back to work.
Union reps for the nurses at Robert Wood Johnson University Hospital sat down once again with hospital leaders today to continue hashing out the sticking points of a deal to hopefully get the nurses back to work. Those sticking points focused on penalties that the unions requested if the hospital doesn't meet agreed upon staffing ratios.
If they're not staffed appropriately, if they don't meet the staffing guidelines, then again, the only way the guidelines are enforceable is if there's a penalty. So I guess that's what we need, enforceable guidelines with the penalty.
The nurses union has proposed a $20 per hour penalty anytime a nursing unit is short-staffed. But union president Judy Danella tells us the hospital is looking for some wiggle room on that penalty by proposing what's called a core deficit.
They want to have, it's called a core deficit, which means they can go below a certain amount of staff without still meeting the penalty. And if that ever took place, it wouldn't be an enforceable guideline.
The negotiations hinge on whether a 15 to 18% core deficit will be included in a deal. John August from Cornell University says negotiations like this are happening all around the state and country and are the result of the bleeding of nursing staff that was exacerbated by COVID.
The industry as a whole needs to be held accountable to not advancing a greater reaching out to their staff and working in a collaborative way to figure this out. It is the management who has control. They don't want to give up that control, and they should give up some of that control and empower nurses to sit down and be a partner, you know, in figuring out solutions.
Solutions to how they can improve their systems of care delivery, something he thinks should be a focus in this post-COVID conversation around how hospitals should be running. And he believes nurses should be a part of that conversation.
Include them in what I think is necessary, which is a kind of realignment of the way we actually deliver care by using a much larger team with more advanced capacity and abilities. Certainly technology can enhance that. And finally, I think what the real issue is the people, nurses in particular, who are leaving the profession because they don't feel like they have control over what they're doing. Some of that is staffing, but I think it really has to do with the deeper question of what is their role in actually determining care delivery.
Robert Wood Johnson Hospital leadership has maintained they want their nurses back to work as quickly as possible, saying in a statement they've continued to offer language in support of top-of-market wages, as well as safe staffing standards that meet or exceed levels set forth by legislation in states like California and in a number of hospital labor settlements across the country. Both sides hopeful that a resolution can be reached soon. I'm Joanna Gagas, NJ Spotlight News.
We'll be right back.